What's going on, guys? Welcome to Inside the Horseshoe. My name is Matt. And the Indianapolis Colts lose to the Green Bay Packers 16-10. I'm not happy. I'm going to talk about why in a minute. But before I do, if you're new, if you haven't already, I would greatly appreciate it if you click that subscribe button. Also, click the bell icon so you're notified when I upload a video or when I go live. If you like the video, smack the like button. Leave your thoughts in the comments down below. And if you have a Twitter, make sure you follow me on Twitter at horseshoe_pod. There is a link in the description down below. So this game went pretty much the exact opposite of what I expected. Outside of like one thing, it went the opposite of what I thought was going to happen. I thought the Colts offense was going to get down the field and they were going to put points on the board. And heck, I thought the defense was going to be able to get like a pick six or something in this game. That's why I had the score being as high for the Colts as I did, and the offense was terrible. Outside of like two players, the offense was absolutely terrible today. And I thought the defense was going to be able to shut down the run. Well, in the first half, they did not. They were awful in the first half. The second half, they did play better against the run. I saw the numbers for what Green Bay had in the first half was, in the first half rushing, they had 237 yards, which is so much worse than last week. But the second half, they only gave up 23 yards. So they definitely did better against the run. And you could tell because of the score and just because of the offense, Green Bay wasn't really able to do a whole lot outside of that one deep throw that Malik Willis had to Romeo Doubs, I believe. It was like a 49 or 50-some yard pass. Something like that. And it was a good pass by Willis for sure. But that was it. And here's the thing. Willis didn't really do anything passing the football. But he didn't need to. Because they were able to have success running the football in the first half. And again, the Colts, they had opportunities to win this game. Like, for example, that fumble that Josh Jacobs had as he was going to the end zone could have been 17-0, but he fumbled it. We get the ball back. If you go down the field and put at least 3 points on the board, I mean, we at least are going to overtime because I'm sure we at least get a field goal range for Matt Gay, but didn't take advantage of any of the opportunities that we had. Offensively speaking, like I said, everybody was terrible except for two players. Anthony Richardson, one drive does not change my thoughts on how he played today. Anthony Richardson was bad. He was terrible. Absolutely terrible. Two of the picks he threw were horrible. Overthrew Alec Pierce on one, ended up getting picked. That was his first. And then he threw it to Pittman, but Pittman was like covered like a blanket, and that ended up being picked off. The third interception, look, I'm not going to freak out about it. It was a Hail Mary. It got smacked in the air, and Green Bay was able to grab it. Okay, I'm not going to freak out about that. But, yeah, he was absolutely terrible. Outside of that second-to-last drive in the fourth quarter, they were able to move the ball down the field. He looked pretty good. He was getting the ball where he needed to be. But besides that, he was absolutely terrible today. The receivers dropping balls. A.D. Mitchell, you got to catch the football. He dropped, what, three passes in this game? Only got one catch, and he had 30 yards. That was it. And he almost dropped that one too. He was close to dropping that one. Alec Pierce was the best receiver again today. Five catches, 56 yards, had a touchdown. He was the best receiver. Like when you talk about the amount of yards he's had, the amount of catches he had, like he was the best receiver. Michael Pittman Jr., where are you? We're paying you like you're a number one receiver. Where is Michael Pittman Jr.? Three catches for 21 yards on seven targets. Unacceptable. And look, one of those targets was an interception. I'm not going to freak out about him. But that one deep ball that he threw to Pittman, why did you not fight for it, Pittman? Got to fight for those balls. Yeah, but Alec Pierce played good today. So that's good. And then Jonathan Taylor. Anytime we ran the football, it seemed like he was getting big yards. He was getting 10 to like 29 yards when he was running the football. So, I mean, and then we took him out for the rest of the game. Like, did he even play in the fourth quarter? I think he did, but I'm not 100% sure. Had 12 carries. That is not enough for Jonathan Taylor. 12 carries for 103 yards. That's a good job. Like, I'm happy with those numbers when you have 12 carries, but he should have got the ball more. And they kept going away from the run after he was having good runs. Like, when your passing offense is not doing anything at all, and Taylor is able to run the ball and get good yards, don't go away from it. Keep running with it. And look, some people think he might be hurt because they took him out for like three series. I don't know. Offense was bad outside of Taylor and outside of Pierce. That's really it. Defensively, first half could not stop the run. Again, allowed over 230 yards just in the first half. Josh Jacobs had over 110 rushing yards in the first half. Had pretty much the same numbers that Joe Mixon did last week. Like, what are we doing? What are we doing? Our run defense was awful in the first half. Like I said, it got better in the second half, but it's not enough to make me feel confident going forward. You're playing Chicago. They have a good run game. I'm nervous about that, if I'm going to be honest, because they haven't proven they can stop the run. And they did not force Malik Willis to win the game with his arm. They're able to run the football. And look, they did most of their scoring in the first quarter. That's all they needed to do. That's it. So, not really happy. And then, of course, Buckner had a pretty bad injury in this game. As he was going down, it looked like his leg bent. I'm just hoping that it's not something that's a season-ending injury. I'm hoping he didn't, like, break his leg or break his ankle or something. Hopefully, he just twisted it or something, and they just didn't want to put him back in the game to risk the injury getting worse. But, yeah, overall, not happy with this game. Blown opportunities. Offense didn't look good. Defense was not good as well. But that's going to do it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. I've been Matt, Bleed Blue. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, make sure you watch one of these other two videos. They're cool. Also, if you're new, please click the subscribe button as well as the bell icon. I greatly appreciate your support.